The biggest Bayern event Europe has ever seen is down to the wire. Eight high roller specialists remain in the hunt for the title. Eugene Kachalov and Daniel Negreanu took the 1 and 2 spots in the inaugural Super High Roller at the 2011 PCA.
The very next year at the PCA, I made the final table again. And now this is the third, and I'm here again. I wish there was one every week.
Also making the journey from Canada is 2010 World Series main event winner Jonathan Duhamel.
There's only 6 players that will be in the money, and right now we're 8. You don't make the money. Might as well buzz the first hand.
High-stakes pro Patrick Antonius welcomes the action to his doorstep.
I'm very happy to walk down 5 minutes from my apartment and the EPT Grand Final is Monaco.
Two previous high roller champions are looking to add a super title to their resumes.
It would definitely mean so much for me to win because I don't have a super high roller title yet.
Japan's Masakagawa relishes these big buy-in formats.
I'm coming every year. Monte Carlo final every year.
But standing in everyone's way is the massive chip leader, Justin Bonomo.
Going to the final table, I feel great. I have 39% of the chips in play, which is just a ridiculous thing to even ask for. Everything went my way. I could have had this chip lead in my sleep.
Super high stakes, super high pressure. This is the Super High Roller final table. PokerStars and Monte Carlo Casino EPT Grand Final Super High Roller attracts only the best players and biggest bankrolls. This final table combined has over $52 million in live tournament earnings, 7 World Series of Poker bracelets, 4 World Poker Tour titles, and 2 EPT titles. 38 players started this event, all anteing up €100,000 for their seat. 7 of them rebought. This created a jaw-dropping prize pool of over €4.4 million and a first-place prize of over €1.6 million. Previously, we saw the top 3 players on the all-time money list do battle.
Let's have some fun.
And it was Daniel Negreanu, currently ranked 3rd, who got the better of the other 2. First, knocking out Phil Ivey with pocket aces. Then sending Eric Seidel to the rail for the 2nd time this year in a super high roller event.
Always good.
A win here would see Daniel leapfrog both players to the number 1 spot. Many other high-profile players were also sent to the rail, most of them falling victim to Justin Bonomo. He was a dominant force throughout day 2 and finished the day's proceedings knocking out the runner-up in the PCA Super High Roller, Dan Shack, and then Anatoly Gertovoy, who became the final table bubble boy. So let's see how the players stack up coming into today. Sitting in the number 1 spot is overwhelming chip leader Justin Bonomo. He starts with just over $4.6 million. Next up is 2010 Monaco High Roller champ Tobias Reinkemeyer. He's playing a stack of more than $1.7 million. Close behind him with just over $1.5 million is High Roller specialist and current number 3 on the all-time money list, Daniel Negreanu. Fourth in chips, French team pro and last year's Grand Final High Roller winner, Elke. He's playing $1.2 million. Following him, his good friend and our only non-professional, Masakagawa. He's sitting with just over $1 million in chips. The first of the short stacks is 2010 World Series main event winner, Jonathan Duhamel. The Canadian starts with just shy of $600,000. Sitting on a little over half of that is online heads-up specialist, Patrick Antonius. He starts the day with $303,000. And trailing at the back of the pack with just over 6 big blinds is Eugene Kachalov. He's going to have to make something happen early if he wants that second Super High Roller title.
Let's get some cards in the air. Let's light this candle.
Congrats on bubbling, two of you. Congrats on maximum pain.
Daniel is lifting his leg on the fire hydrant that is karma. Anybody know what the blinds are?
For the benefit of unobservant types, such as Joe Stapleton, 15 and 30,000, with a 4,000 ante.
Cool.
Action folded to Masakagawa. Pocket queens.
Now, I don't want to be too harsh on Masakagawa, so all I'll say is that he's a welcome face in any high-stakes setting.
He raises, a min raise to 60K. Eugene Kachalov moves all in with A6.
Eugene's super short, but he just shoved a weak ace and a tight early razor and has no fold equity.
Kagawa snap calls.
Eugene knows that can't be good.
Swing the bad one. It's a good one.
I don't think I can root for you anymore.
No?
No, we're getting close to that
tough,
time.
Huh?
Yeah. Sorry.
No one's rooting for me at this table.
No, not anymore.
All alone here.
We're friends, but
since when does Daniel care about the min cash?
Good one.
It's not about the min cash, it's about not having the max loss. 100,000 euros.
No ace on that flop.
Despite all the working out he's been doing, Eugene is in bad shape here.
There's an 87% chance he busts in eighth. That gives him a bit of hope.
No more.
Pretty sure there's one guy at this table who's not laughing. And there he is. Taking it pretty well considering how grim things are.
Good luck, guys.
No ace or six on the river. Eugene Kachalov exits the super high roller.
And it's time to say goodbye to Eugene, the final table machine.
The bubble time. Always fun coming seventh when they pay six. You're next, Patrick. What's up? Your move.
Daniel's got more confidence than me at a Fat Farm mixer, which I attend regularly.
King Jack for Masakagawa under the gun.
Under the gun, huh? And right after I got done saying how tight he is. Way to make me look like a jerk, Kagawa.
He raises to 60k, gets followed from Duhamel, Negreanu, Reinkemeyer, and Bonomo, but Elky has ace-queen in the small blind.
This is kind of an awkward spot for Elky. For a lot of players, this is going to be the very bottom of their range for out-of-position 3-betting an under-the-gun raiser. They're pretty deep, so if he does 3-bet, he should expect to get flatted quite a bit.
Well, it is a re-raise, a 3-bet to 166,000. Patrick Antonius folds the big blind.
Having said that, Kagawa calling here would be pretty bad. He's going to be dominated a lot. It just so happens in this case that he is drawing live.
Kagawa makes the call. He will play the flop in position. And that flop is king high.
Wow, Kagawa paired his live card. Elky's going to fire off at least one bet here.
Elky continues for 122,000.
Kagawa should still be wary of being dominated, but he certainly can't fold now.
He makes the call.
Beware pickpockets and loose preflop calls.
An ace on the turn. Elky moves in front again.
Bazinga!
And a cheeky check.
This is a great check. Elky doesn't want to bet and get shoved on, as he'd likely have to fold.
10 on the river. Elky's pair of aces is the best hand.
Elky probably wouldn't have gotten paid off for two bets by a worse hand, so why even risk it on the turn? This should be a pretty easy bet for Elky on the river. Give him a second. He's daydreaming about this really awesome round of StarCraft he played back in the day. Go Zerg!
He bets 277,000.
Kagawa probably doesn't want to fold what was very likely to be the best hand on the flop, but after a 3-bet preflop, I don't know what he could really be beating here. It's really easy for Elky to bluff when the ace hits the turn, so when he checks and bets the river, it's not likely for him to be bluffing. Elky looks how I look when I want someone to fold. No idea if that's intentional.
Kagawa makes the call. Elky shows the best hand.
This hand was a crucial misstep for Kagawa, and at this stage, it's translatable into real cash.
Elky and Massa have been going to dinner every night here in Monaco, but there are no friends at the poker table. Elky took about 600k off him there.
I just won the high roller event in Berlin, and it really felt amazing because it was such a tough field, especially the heads up against Moman was lasting for hours. He beat me before in Vegas, so I kind of got my revenge, and he's a really great player, so it feels really good, and my confidence is really to the roof now, so hopefully I can make a double here. There's more high rollers here in Monaco than Bahamas. It's kind of here, it's the home of the high rollers, so there's also like much more recreational players, which is great. I feel really great going into the final table for sure. I don't have one of the biggest stacks, but I have a playable stack for sure, and I have position on Justin, who's gonna abuse it a lot, so hopefully I can pick my spots well and manage to pass it with a good stack and hope to win it, yeah. Oh, it would definitely be amazing for me to win here because I don't have a super high world title yet. I have so many titles, but not this one. And also because it's such a historical event, because it's the biggest buy-in ever held in Europe in such a tough field. So definitely it would be a super good win for me.
I seriously can't believe this is the EPT's third super high roller and Elky still hasn't won one. It's pathetic, really. Pathetic, Elky.
Action on Tobias Reinkemeyer. 7-5 off, that'll go in the muck. Chip leader Justin Bonomo. Jack 4. He folds. Pocket aces for Elky.
Yeah, Elky runs pretty good in high rollers. I'm sensing a raise.
Your senses aren't letting you down. 60,000 he makes it. Antonius and Kagawa both fold. Jonathan Duhamel has king-queen suited.
This is almost always a 3-bet, and Jonathan really doesn't have that many chips.
I'm all in.
He shoves. Negreanu gives up the big blind. Elky calls. Jonathan's not happy.
Now, I'm not sure what he said there, but I think he was expressing disappointment. Biggest bubble in EPT history. Again, I'm not really sure what he's saying, but I know he can't be happy.
Oh. 19 bigs, I guess.
There's really not much Jonathan could do. It's a great hand to reshove, and he had plenty of fold equity. Still, file listener are things that make you go, ugh!
That wasn't the flop he wanted. He now has 5% equity.
He has flopped a draw. It's not over yet.
It is now. The bubble has burst.
Hello, boys.
Good game, John.
Jonathan Duhamel.
Yeah, there's not much I can do.
Busts in seventh.
This was gonna have to happen to someone, but I feel just terrible.
Like Dustin.
Well, how do you think Jonathan Duhamel's feeling right now?
There's your answer.
Welcome back to the PokerStars and Monte Carlo Casino EPT Grand Final Super High Roller. A fancy seaworthy vessel is a must-have here in Monaco, and now our finalists are in the money, they might be contemplating an upgrade.
Look, I don't want to say Monaco's expensive, but the vending machine in the lobby only accepts gold bars.
The next player to bust will earn a min cash, 310,000 euros. Remember, the winner will receive more than 1.6 million. Action's been forwarded to Masakagawa. Folds Jack 10 from the cutoff. Ace King suited for Daniel Negreanu.
What a fine looking hand on the button.
Raises to 68,000. King Jack suited for Reinkemeyer in the small blind.
Bit of a cooler. Reinkemeyer is dominated and he's almost certainly 3-betting. Little shot Daniel folds when it gets around to him. This could get ugly.
He does re-raise to 185,000.
Yeah, we could easily see a fourth bet here. Really tough to give either of these guys credit for monsters given their positions. What a setup.
Re-raise. Bonomo, four bets to 405,000.
I just don't think you're ever laying down ace-king suited in this situation.
Daniel shoves.
See ya, Tobias.
I got a total of...
The German folds.
1.2.
That's... I have a total of 2.
No, I said 1.2, oh. That's 1.
Yeah, I call.
Yeah, all right.
From those positions, there was literally no shot the money wasn't going in.
Classic.
Yep.
You had a king? I would have much rather play just against you.
Daniel flipping at a bit of a disadvantage with that king being folded. Bonomo's good like that.
Oh, I have a second, third, fourth, and a fifth in these. This would be poetic straight.
I have a fifth and a sixth. This is my,
well,
only my third one.
For six, I don't think. Unless you lose this, then steam.
Daniel always thinking three moves ahead.
So Negreanu, the player at risk, and the player who needs to hit.
That's a good flop for him.
10 on the flop.
Man, now I have a straight. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Spoiler alert, Daniel finishes in sixth place.
All right. Good luck, guys. Good luck, good luck.
Yeah, somehow he knew that 1% shot wasn't going to get there.
A pathetic €300,000 min cash for Daniel Negreanu. The last min cash I had didn't even cover my bar tab.
Yeah, good hand, bro. Okay, good luck, guys.
It's really impressive that he is 3 for 3 in these tournaments.
Where my money at?
Quite an accomplishment.
Yeah. This is the walk of shame right here?
Not hardly.
Justin, you calling if I shove? I guess so, right? Yeah.
You mean if Daniel shoves too?
No, if Daniel folds, if
yeah,
I shove,
certainly.
I really like these events. You know, I wish there were more of them. I feel like I bring out my best for these events. And unfortunately, this isn't the result I was hoping for, but a cash is a cash, you know, and they're big caches.
Daniel's min cash was enough profit for him to free roll every single EPT main event for next season. There is going to be a next season, right? Because I got debts.
Masakagawa has pocket fours under the gun.
The value of these pocket pairs go up as the head count goes down.
Brian Kamaya mucks the 8-4. 8-6 suited for Justin Bonomo, who's extended his monster chip lead after busting Negreanu. He folds from the button. Elky gives up the small blind. Queen 10 for Patrick Antonius in the big blind. He looks a little bit confused.
Not really a hand you want to go crazy with, but seeing a flop's cool, especially if you're in at a discount.
He will call, and we go to the flop. Boom, top pair for Patrick.
Top pair and the best hand. Checks to the razor, playing in flow. Kagawa not c-betting here would be a losing play in the long run. In the short run, however...
65,000 he makes it.
Raise.
Patrick check raises to 135.
This raise is borderline genius. If it works, I'll tell you why.
Kagawa calls.
See, a lot of these rich businessman guys like to try to get all lippy with the big pros and try to pick them off. Making little bets and raises gives them the leeway to get all heroic at a price.
King of clubs on the turn.
Antonius picks up a flush draw to go with the best hand.
He's a 97% favorite to win the hand. He bets 100,000.
That turn card was pretty terrible for Kagawa and subsequently also for Patrick.
Kagawa gets away from it.
Patrick was less likely to lose that hand than he was to wake up ugly tomorrow. He is gorge.
Still short on chips though. Blinds are up to 20 and 40,000 with a 5K ante. Tobias Reinkemeyer looks down at pocket jacks.
Will we see the min raise?
We will. Justin Bonomo also has jacks.
This should be interesting. I think there's little chance Bonomo just flats.
He three bets to 190,000. Elki and Antonius fold. Masakagawa, king queen off.
Most of the time, this is a fold to a raise and a re-raise.
I'm worried.
He shoves!
Now, this might look really bad, but it's actually a pretty good move. These guys are going to be opening and three-betting pretty light, even though they happen to have big hands. In this case, king-queen isn't doing all that bad against their calling ranges either. Most of the time, you're hoping to not get called.
Hold on.
Ryan Kumar re-shoves.
At this point, I don't think Justin can fold 1.3 million more to win 2.4 million. He could very well be ahead of both players.
I call.
He calls.
Kagawa's not in terrible shape. He's a coin flip to win in three ways.
I have 10. Wow.
You're a slight favorite, actually.
One time. They don't cover.
Team Germany, railing Reinkemeyer.
Spade is am besten mein Power.
Nee, ich brauche Spades. Spades. Spades ist gut,
ja. Just run out like a 7 high straight. Give us all our money back.
I'm good with that.
Good news for Kagawa is no one can flop a set.
Ryan Kamaya is now drawing to a chop. Bonomo's got a backdoor flush draw.
Bring a heart one time, just for the feel. At least one, just for the fun.
Don't be so mean.
It's kind of fun.
That takes away the heart draw.
119.
No, thank you.
Three of diamonds.
A 9, a king, or a queen, and Kagawa doubles up. Anything else, and he is out of here.
Oh,
It's an ace on the river, so Kagawa's eliminated. Bonomo and Reinkemeyer chop the pot for 350k each.
You know, I give Masa Kagawa a hard time for being a rich fish, but in the end, it did take two big-name pros to take him out. Not too shabby.
He will collect 354,500 euros for his fifth-place finish.
Boy, that was barely a prize jump at all from sixth place. Top-heavy, anyone?
Nice doing business with you.
Yeah.
Bonomo still crushing.
If you travel to Monte Carlo and you're playing the Super High Roller Tournament, that's the tournament you care about. The side events, they're great and all, but you want to win the 100K. This is my third 100K event, and I've had massive chip leads in the first two. Both of them, I was pretty much massive chip leader at the end of day one. So I was actually kind of feeling weird for not having the chip lead. I had already rebought, which is, you know, pretty expensive for 100K euros, just to say rebuy, please. Day two, everything was different. Everything went my way. I could have had this chip lead in my sleep. I'm not too proud to say that at the poker table I've been referred to as an emotionless cyborg before. One thing I've always said about live tournament play is that if you have a style that you really define yourself with, you're doing something wrong. When I sit down to any table, it's based on the situation around me, how I define my style. A lot of players like to say that, I don't care about the money, you know, 1.6 million, you know, I'll make that in a few years anyway. I really want the fame. For me, I gotta be honest, it's a lot of money. The glory's great and all, but I have to take the money over it.
ZJ stands for Justin's online handle, ZJustin. Contrary to popular belief, it does not stand for the Zhejiang province of China, known as the land of fish and rice with a population of over 54 million. Not that, just his online handle.
For future reference, Joe, while you're on this side of the Atlantic, it's a Z. Ace-King for Patrick Antonius.
Oh, that British sense of humor. Raise it up.
He makes it 80,000.
The hammer. Fold it up.
Jack 10 for Bonomo in the big blind.
Easy call out of the big blind.
Heads up to the flop. Queen, queen, eight with two clubs.
Antonius has the best hand, but Bonomo has flopped a gut shot to the nut straight.
Justin checks to the razor. Patrick does not continue. He checks behind and hits a king on the turn.
Antonius turns top pair. Justin picks up an up and down draw now. Now Bonomo's leading out.
Betting 140,000.
Semi-bluffing. He knows Patrick's going to have to fold anything that doesn't have a serious piece of this board. Don't see Patrick folding top pair, nor should he in general or specifically now.
Patrick will call, and we will go to the river.
Justin likely knows the jig is up.
Nine on the river gives Justin the straight.
There's a few hands out there that beat him, but likely Justin is going to bet here for value. He knows Patrick's got to have something decent.
480k in the pot. Justin makes it 380.
That's almost half Patrick's remaining stack. You can't really blame him if he calls here. This all comes down to how often he thinks Justin is bluffing with this line. It doesn't look very bluffy to me. Patrick with just shy of 20 big blinds left behind, 10-ish if he makes the call.
He's not calling. He's moving all in.
This is crazy.
I call.
Easiest decision you'll make all day.
Maybe Patrick was turning his hand into a bluff, but no, given that reaction, I think maybe he thought he was going for razor thin value.
We'll win this pot. That's a big one.
He also really didn't have much fold equity. Had to be a value shove.
Patrick Antonius busts in fourth, collecting 443,000 euros.
Justin Bonomo is just running over this final table. Well, the good news for Patrick is that he lives here in Monaco, and the cab ride home should only cost him about a third of his winnings.
What do you make of Patrick's shove there? Let us know your thoughts. Tweet using the hashtag EPTGrandFinal. Welcome back to the PokerStars and Monte Carlo Casino EPT Grand Final Super High Roller. Before the break, we saw Patrick Antonius raise with Ace-King. He was called by chip leader Justin Bonomo with Jack-10. Both players checked the flop. Bonomo bet 140,000 on the turn. Patrick called. On the river, Justin bet 380,000 and Patrick shoved.
Patrick moves. All in.
But did Patrick have to risk it all? We asked some of his peers what they do in this situation.
That pre-flop check, combined with the call on the turn, turns our hand face up to ace-king a lot. It's very clear that we have something that's pretty good and wants to show our hand down.
Justin bets 380,000.
When he bets really big, it's either a bluff or it's a hand that beats us.
On the river, when Justin bets 380, I'm not too excited about it, but I'm probably not gonna fold just because I beat all other kings and bluffs. I wouldn't be happy about calling, but I'd probably just call.
CJ can have like many hands there and be trying to bluff the spot. I was lean towards a call more often.
What's interesting is if you're really deep or something like that, you could kind of shove or something as a bluff, but with the stack sizes and given the fact that Justin had a lot of chips, I don't think that's ever gonna work. So I would just probably make a really tight fold in that spot.
Patrick moves, all in.
I call.
Open, please. Ace King and Justin will win this pot. Let's have a big round of applause for our fourth place finisher, everybody. Patrick Antonius.
Patrick is a top, top level player, so I've gotta think that he honestly thought he was trying to get thin value from a worse king. Either that or his wife was blowing up his phone. That'll get a guy to make some weird plays.
That is why God created flight safe mode. 6-3 suited. Rankin might fold to the button. And Justin will fold the small blind. Elky gets a walk and he had kings.
Sick read.
You guys are good.
How am I supposed to analyze this?
You should wear darker sunglasses.
Yeah. Make a note to myself for next time.
That is pretty frustrating, though. It sure beats losing with them.
I made a pretty tight fold, actually, like for the button first. And kind of had a feeling, you know?
3-6 of clubs. You had a feeling 3-6 of clubs was no good? Hey, you got a feeling about any lottery numbers, buddy?
Justin's button, and he's raising with Queen-9. Makes it 90,000.
Of course, he's raising now.
Elky folds the small. 7-8 suited for Reinkemeyer in the big.
Nice hand to see a flop with. He's in at a discount, even if he is out of position.
He calls, and we go to the flop. 6-10 king.
Looks like Reinkemeyer is going to take a donk stab at this. He did flop a gut shot.
125,000.
Bonomo has the best hand with queen high. He's also got a gut shot and backdoor clubs.
Bonomo raises. Makes it 340,000 total.
Definitely a semi-bluff. For Tobias, you certainly can't just call and pray to hit your nine. Not much he can do other than come back over the top, which is risky at best with eight high.
Which is why he folds. Which results in more chips for Justin Bonomo.
Well, there's a saying that goes, the first one's always a bluff. Guess that goes for the both of them in this case.
Meanwhile, it's day 1A of the main event here in Monaco. We'll be following that tournament from day 1B onwards. Three-handed action continues in this super high roller tournament. Bonomo on the button with 5-3 suited. Raises, 90,000 total. Elky's folded. Reinkemeyer has ace-7 in the big blind.
Another fine spot for a just call. No need to get crazy with a weak ace. Even when you're ahead, you're usually not that far ahead.
He does call. Bonomo with the advantage of position, the betting lead, and a ludicrously big chip stack. Seriously, who has 180 big blinds at this stage of a tournament?
Bonomo!
The flop is 8-5 with two clubs.
Decent flop for Bonomo, who makes a pair and a backdoor straight draw. Reinkemeyer's only got ace high.
Here's the ace of clubs, though. And as people keep telling me, it's all about the backdoors. Bonomo bets 140,000.
Even though we know he's behind in general, I don't think Tobias can fold in this spot all the time.
He elects to check call.
I like the call. Justin's going to be raising tons of hands on the button, so Tobias can't just go folding ace high every dang time on the flop.
The board pairs on the turn.
Raising would have been fine, too.
Ryan Kamaya checks a second time.
Base high was good before. It's still good now. Looks like Bonomo is going to keep firing away.
That's 380,000.
Second pair is pretty susceptible, and obviously he can get value out of ace high hands. This is a perfectly good turn card for Tobias to keep calling on, usually.
He does call. 1.25 million in the middle. One card to come. And that card is an ace.
Terrible river card for Bonomo. Great for Tobias.
Tobias decides not to bet.
It's not the river card I wanted.
He checks, and Bonomo wisely checks behind.
Tobias looks a little surprised at the river card. Great value bet by Bonomo on the turn. Just didn't work out for him this time. He bet when he had the best hand, checked when he didn't. Pretty well played. Bonomo gives a little bit back.
Ryan Kamaya in the hunt for a Super High Roller trophy to add to the high roller title he won here in Monaco back in season 6.
Last time I've been in this building was the one when I won the 25k high roller 2 years ago. Good memories and some flashbacks, and it felt great to be like on the exact same venue, on the same final table basically, but just with a little higher buy-in this time. I think this tournament is pretty unique, first of all because it's the first ever European Poker Tour event in this kind of buy-in area, and second of all because Monte Carlo is just the perfect place to host a tournament like this. Most places where poker players travel, they are like the rich people, but here they're really like the poor guys, you know? And it's like, if you see like a Mercedes driving there, you're like, I'm used to like better cars. There were quite a few rich businessmen who decided to play. A lot of them are really unpredictable because they really don't care about the money. They have so much money that like 100k is just play money for them, and if they busted 10 times, they would have just rebought 10 times. So it's not like just easy money, you know?
Tobias isn't kidding about Monaco. I saw a car with a bumper sticker that said, "My other car is a yacht." Then the yacht actually had a bumper sticker that said, "My other yacht is a Harrier jet."
And the Harrier jet?
Space shuttle. You want to keep going?
Bonomo in action again, raising his button. Makes it 90,000. Jack 10 for Tobias Reinkemeyer.
Jack 10's an okay hand to call with, but I expect these guys to start ramping up the preflop aggression while playing out of position.
Well, it seems that Reinkemeyer is still happy to play flops out of position. He just calls.
Okay. Also, where the heck has Elky been?
Yeah, they're not heads up yet, but I wouldn't blame you for thinking we were at that stage.
Another pretty good flop for Bonomo. A pair, a gut shot, backdoor straight flush. All looks pretty good at this stage of the game.
Reinkemeyer checks, Bonomo bets.
Perfectly fine spot for Tobias to just give it up.
There is an alternative.
Oh boy.
Which is to bluff by check raising to 385,000.
I think this is just one of those frustration raises that can happen sometimes when you keep missing flops. I wonder if Bonomo thinks the same thing. This is pretty much a gin flop with a hand like 8-6 off. Don't think you can just give it up.
Can I see your chips?
I definitely wouldn't expect to see just a call here.
I'm all in.
Bonomo shoves on him!
Big, fat semi-bluff. Really good shove. Even if he gets called, it's pretty likely he's drawing live. Tobias was frustrated before. He's got to be even more frustrated now. And where the heck is Elky? Oh, there he is.
They've played 52 hands at the final table. And these are the 52 hands that Justin Bonomo's been dealt.
Justin's played 25 of them, 48%. Not too high considering it's three-handed, but what I notice here is how often he plays his button and his blinds and how rarely he plays from other positions. That plus his aggressive style and a little bit of run good have resulted in his better than 2-to-1 win rate with not a ton of premium hands in there either. Bonomo!
He's got 9-10 on the button here. There's his standard open to 90,000. Elky folds what seems like the 800th hand in a row. Line come out with king, queen in the big blind.
Surely he's going to 3-bet this time.
Nope, he just calls.
And stop calling him Shirley, right?
The flop gives Reinkemeyer the second nut flush draw.
I think with such a strong draw and a hand that's going to be good a lot of the time, he should probably try to get some money in here. Justin was the pre-flop aggressor, so the check is fine.
Justin bets 140,000. We've seen this pattern before.
With 10 high and a gut shot. Now, Tobias has the second nut flush draw on two overcards. It's a crazy strong hand against a button range like Justin's. A raise here would barely be a semi-bluff. It's almost a value check raise, and baffling. This is just a pretty weak play.
The turn gives Bonomo a straight.
Reinkemeyer let him get there. Check raise on the flop, and this hand is over.
Reinkemeyer checks. This is the point where Justin Bonomo normally bets 380,000.
I think that's a pretty solid guess, James.
Oh, he's mixing it up. He made it 375 this time.
Oh, you are so wrong. At this point, there's not much Reinkemeyer can do. Raising here would be disastrous about 80% of the time.
He lets it go. A missed opportunity on the flop. He gives up another huge chunk of his stack. And Bonomo's now playing 191 big blinds.
Having more than twice average when you're three-handed is, good.
Running well, playing well, as three-handed action continues in Monaco.
If you want to play in an EPT event, go to PokerStars.com, where there are qualifiers every day.
Night has fallen here in Monaco, and the streets are quiet, as we edge ever closer to crowning the first champion of the PokerStars and Monte Carlo Casino EPT Grand Final Festival. Three players remain in the Super High Roller Tournament, but only one is currently sitting comfortably. Can Justin Bonomo's grip on the table be loosened?
Just remember, General Tarkin, the more you tighten your grip, the more star systems will slip through your fingers.
And what did he do next? He blew up her planet. Thank you. Argument over.
So you're saying Justin Bonomo is going to blow up their planet?
I'm saying that chip stack in front of him is a Death Star.
Point taken.
King, queen in the small blind. Blind's now 25 and 50,000. Bonomo raises to 115,000. Elky with king 10 suited.
Elky's hand is almost too strong for a 3-bet here. It's a great hand to take a flop in position.
He calls.
Even though we know he's dominated.
Jack, deuce, six. Elky with the second nut flush draw.
Big flop for Elky. Bonomo likely to continue.
He does. 125,000.
Elky should have no problem peeling at least one card here. Bonomo's building this pot for him.
Elky calls, nearly 500k in the middle. A queen on the turn, top pair for Bonomo. Elky now has an up and down draw to go with his flush draw.
That's right, Elky has picked up equity, or as I like to call it, elquity.
Bonomo bets again, 375,000.
I honestly don't see how Elky can fold such a huge draw, especially since a lot of the time Justin's supposed to have air here. It's just kind of a cooler that Justin happened to catch one of the few cards he's likely to call with.
Elky shoves.
I call.
Justin checks he's got the queen and makes the call.
Elky looks like he's trying to change the cards with his mind.
He's got 14 outs. Any ace, any nine, any spade.
But only one shot to hit one of them. Elke actually goes into all these tournaments believing he is going to win. Tons of pressure on him right now. He is really sweating this card.
An 8 on the river. It's a blank. Elke's eliminated in third.
So close. I mentioned how much Elke believes he's going to win every tournament. I honestly don't even think he realizes he loses until days later. Justin Bonomo is so unstoppable, they made a movie about him starring Denzel Washington.
And with Elke exiting the building, we are down to two. Well, this heads-up battle is likely to be a bit of a David versus Goliath confrontation. Tobias Reinkemeyer is no slouch. He's got plenty of heads-up experience. He's had success in this very room, but he's facing an uphill struggle. For Justin Bonomo, this is his third super high roller tournament and his third cash. And he's going into this heads-up clash with more than a 5-1 chip lead. It's an understatement to say he's sitting pretty with a stack of over 9.6 million. Tobias, in the shadows, with a stack just shy of 1.7 million. It's time to do battle. One of these two players will be crowned the inaugural European Super High Roller Champion here at the EPT Grand Final.
In seat number one, we have Justin Bonomo. In seat number two, we have Tobias
Reinkemeyer.
They will be playing for 1.64 million.
I remember there were NTs like 2 years ago when I was playing, so I don't know. Maybe they changed it.
Well, that wasn't a super high roller now, was it? No, it wasn't, because this is the first one we've ever done in Europe.
Justin Bonomo raises his button with Jack 6 off. King Jack suited for Tobias.
Rankemeyer's got a very strong hand heads up. We know he's got Bonomo dominated. This is a perfect spot for a three bet.
He calls.
I seriously do not know why Tobias never three bets. It's bizarre.
8-9-5 flop with two hearts.
Though he has the best hand, this is a really bad flop for Tobias. Bonomo has flopped a gut shot. Oh no, and it looks like he's gonna donk it.
He does, betting 125,000.
This move is questionable. You're donking into the preflop aggressor on a board that's terrible for your hand and also hits a huge part of his range.
Bonomo makes the call. Four of clubs on the turn.
Puts way more draws out there, none of which Tobias could even touch with a 10-foot pole. Let's see if he keeps bluffing at it.
He checks.
Nope. It's a great spot for Justin to keep the pressure on.
Bet's 250,000.
Really not much Tobias can do here. I'm not sure what his strategy is, but it's not working so far.
He folds the best hand.
Justin Bonomo is having everything go his way today, including his opponent's moves. Tobias is still super short stacked, but in a way it kind of takes the pressure off having the odds literally stacked against you.
Meanwhile, Justin Bonomo is closing in on the 10 million chip mark. Tobias Reinkemeyer will post the small blind of 25,000. Justin Bonomo the big blind of 50,000. Reinkemeyer will have the button. He'll be first to speak pre-flop. King 10 suited.
On the button. Easy raise.
So he calls.
All right, well, all this deception really isn't doing Tobias any favors. It might be time to change his game plan. Oh boy, wait a second.
Bonomo with ace jack. Raises. Puts 125,000 on top.
A lot of players are gonna shove here, like almost all of them. Another famous Tobias was a never nude. This one is apparently a never raise. Feel bad rooting for him to shove since he's behind and he'll get snap called, but honestly, that's what he should do.
No, he elects to call and we go to the flop. That flop gives Tobias top pair. It gives Justin a gut shot.
Well, Tobias has finally hit a flop. Let's see if he can capitalize it all. Action on Bonomo.
He had the pre-flop betting lead. He continues for 200,000.
Now does Tobias just call? There are some straight draws to protect against.
He shoves.
And with all the giving up Tobias has been doing, Justin has to know he's behind. Still with two overs and a gut shot, putting this thing to bed right now has to be awfully tempting. As it stands, he's not a huge dog.
Gives it some consideration, but decides to fold.
Good disciplined fold. Statistically, he dodged giving Tobias the double up. There's Tobias's girlfriend, Sabina. A little smile from her boyfriend. Psst, it's me in the booth. Look at the camera if you're into it. Yes! Justin has taken complete control of this match. If Tobias needs top pair in order to win a pot, this is going to be an even tougher row to hoe than it already is. No offense to the lady on the rail.
Small pocket pair for Tobias.
All right, it's heads up. You've got to raise your pairs.
He does raise. Makes it 125,000.
Re-raise.
Ace-queen.
Definite re-raise.
Question is, how will Tobias respond to that re-raise?
Well, I don't think you can just call with a pair. You certainly can't fold it.
So Justin makes it 350,000 total.
Justin could easily be 3-betting super light.
Come on.
Ryan Kamai moves all in.
I call.
Justin calls.
It's a race and the biggest coin flip of Justin Bonomo's life. He's a slight dog, but if he ends up on top, he walks with 1.64 million euros.
Plus the super high roller title and trophy. And there is an ace on the flop. Bonomo takes the lead and is on the verge of victory.
Awfully reserved reactions considering the money at stake.
Ryan Kamai needs a 4 to survive. And he needs it on the river. There's a 95% chance we're about to crown a champion. It's a 7 on the river. Bonomo is the winner. Was there ever any doubt? He's been in control of this final table all the way.
Yeah, getting to second without ever putting your chips at risk is pretty impressive.
Yeah, I was pretty happy that you busted out. But obviously.
All things considered, this was a pretty quick final. Kachalov and Duhamel bubbled. Daniel Negreanu secured his third super high roller cash. Ryan Kamai gets more than $1 million for second. Bonomo takes the top prize.
Justin Bonomo, was there ever a point where you were really sweating it?
Yeah, to be honest, in previous 100K events, I played, this is my third one. I've just ran like God day one and chip led day one. And then ran out of luck when the stakes got high. It was the opposite this time. Like, day one just had no luck whatsoever. And then as soon as day two started, I just couldn't lose a hand.
You won 1.6 million euros just now. How are you feeling in this moment?
I don't think it's sunk in yet. Ask me again in 24 hours.
So history's been made. The largest buy-in event ever to be held on European soil is over. From a field of 38 world-class players, we got to 8, 6 of whom made the money. But Daniel Negreanu's hopes of topping the all-time money list were crushed. Elky's campaign to secure the only title that's eluded him failed. Ryan Kamai's attempts to replicate his previous success in this arena fell short by just one place. It was Justin Bonomo who stood tall above the rest to reign supreme and become the Super High Roller Champion. Next time, we'll bring you coverage of the main event here in Monaco.